So I'm gonna show you the easiest way to do it. Make sure you have a drum rack. I have one that's just kicks and snares on it because this is what we're gonna use as our trigger. And make sure we have that set up because, hi, I'm Ash. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you the number one mixing technique that honestly changed my life. No kitsy. And we're talking about side chain compression. So let's just jump right in. What is side chain compression? It's a mixing technique, and this is how you get your drums thick. You get them knocking, you get them slapping, and it's used to make certain elements of your song stand out. It uses a trigger to turn everything else down when another sound comes through. So that lets you have really thick drums, get them real loud, and then you don't have to worry about clipping. This is why we made the kick and snare part. Why would you even sidechain to begin with? Genres where you have a lot of low end, it's so dependent on how the drums and the bass sound in context to one another. And sidechaining really helps that out. So let's just dive right in. I'm gonna show you three different ways you can sidechain, and then we'll kind of decide what works. So let's jump into Valorant here.
Nice headshot.
Insane.
Man. The song, not the game. We're gonna look at the Valorant track because especially for bass music, sidechaining is hella importante. And the first way to do it is to make a kick snare channel. So a channel where both your kicks and snares are going, because these are the drums I want to trigger the sidechain. Now there's a few ways that we can do the sidechain, and the first way I learned was with. So we just go in, we bring in our stock compressor like that, click this little triangle, and then there's that magic button. It's called sidechain. So what this does is it will activate the compressor, which makes everything turn down when it hears a trigger. So the trigger we're setting amongst all of these, what are we gonna do? We're going to use the kick snare layer. So this is what the track sounds like without any sidechain at all. And even when I add it, you're probably not hearing anything. This is when we start turning the threshold down. Now, the biggest thing you should be noticing is hearing the drums become a little clearer as you pull threshold down. Now, of course, depending on how much you've produced and depending on your sound system, it might be different. But the essential idea is you can kind of keep bringing this down until you hear the drums a little clearer. Now, you notice when I solo the drop sound, you can actually hear it kind of ducking in and out. That's how we know the sidechains work. With the compressor, super easy to set up. This is the first way that I learned how to sidechain. So honestly, I've been using this way forever, but I've learned a few new ways. And like up until last month, this is all I did my sidechaining on. And I have found a few better ways. Now, what is the drawback to using the compressor? It is easy to set up. It's really good. But the only problem is it's not very consistent when it comes to the actual volume ducking. So if I switch it to this view, you can see that these gray ones are the drop, and this yellow line is the volume reduction that's happening. And you can see that it changes based on obviously the sample that we chose. So the problem is you get super inconsistent volume ducks, which will essentially mess with your mix even more, if that makes sense. So why do I still use this sidechain compressor? Because at the end of the day, it just freaking sounds cool. I love that pumping effect, and it works great in house tracks, especially if you want that pumping sound. That's this baby boy will get you there. The second way that you can sidechain is by using another stock plugin called Utility. So if we go over to my main bass channel here, you'll see that I have a utility. If I turn that on, you're still hearing that pump sound. If I turn the utility off, That's without the sidechain. So what's the utility doing? Put simply, I've just automated the volume through utility. And now the good thing about this, I've literally unlimited control of how the volume duck is gonna be because you are drawing out the automation line yourself. So if you put utility in, you hit A to automate, and then you click on the little gain knob, it'll let you automate gain. And you can hear the difference that makes. Let me play it with the drums and you'll hear the drums just cut right through. I'm drawing the automation as well every time the drum hits. So mixing woes, be gone. And overall, it just sounds much better than the compressor. The only problem is, as you might have probably guessed, this is not automated at all. Once I said I had to manually put it in whenever the drums and the kicks hit, I had to do that. Of course, you can copy paste, but get into certain issues where you're like, oh my God, what if I change the drum beat? Like on this section here, well, look what I had to do. I literally had to change the entire automation. So that's a little bit annoying, but, and I don't even have it on the snare here. So like, I actually forgot that. I should be copy pasting like that. Now it comes through a lot clearer. If you get used to this, you get fast enough, then this is an awesome freaking way to sidechain. But as I said, once you do it, you have to manually do everything. Ash, you're asking, is there a solution? What's level 3? It is a third-party plugin. It is a paid plugin. And I'm normally not like plugin obsessed. There was a time back when I was, and I just had tons and tons of third-party plugins. And at the end of the day, no matter how many plugins you buy, that's not gonna make you a better producer. It's actually getting in and practicing, making something in Ableton or FL or whatever you're using. The only reason I got this plugin is back to the idea of shortcuts. And I only get a plugin if I know that it's gonna help me do something faster. So I can still do everything that the plugin does inside Ableton. So if I lose everything, it's not a big deal, but if it helps me get ideas out faster, then like that's a good trade-off. So introducing Cable Guy's Volume Shaper. That was one. Saw Barely Alive do a tutorial on that. It automated what utility does here with the volume ducking, but you had to set up separate chains for the triggers. And to me, that was like, that's not a shortcut. That's like, that's taking too long. Then I stumbled upon this person's video here where he talks about the importance of volume automation sidechaining versus sidechain compression. Blah! Why do I sound like such a nerd? And this was especially important when it comes to doing sub basses. So I'm gonna link his video here. It's a really, really awesome breakdown on why volume automation is just so much more helpful. But the TLDR of it is when you use the sidechain compressor, the reason why it sounds so inconsistent is because of a phenomenon called bow tying. And this is especially true when it comes to sub bass. It basically warps the waveform in such a way that it causes a crap ton of distortion and clipping. And when you use a sidechain compressor, that's what that does. But if you use a volume automation, it bypasses that completely. But that's a whole other topic. The reason I watched this video is because he showed this plugin called Duck by Devious Machines. And it works just like Cable Guy's Volume Shaper, where you draw in your LFO to do your volume automation for sidechain, but it lets you set it up like a sidechain compressor. So we don't need to create any extra chains. We just set it up the exact same way as we do the normal sidechain compressor that I'm used to, but with the ability to do the more powerful and more effective volume automation sidechain. So number 3 here, we've got Duck, our best friend. And I just literally use these settings. You set it to speed 1/16, this shape for sub basses, but I will change it depending on the bass, so I can do something similar like this, which is basically what The volume automation is for here. You've got all these presets. This is not sponsored, by the way, but Duck, if you wanna throw a sponsor this way, I'm not gonna say no. Let me show you the big difference that this makes. I'm just gonna play the sub bass with the drums. And you're noticing just a bunch of clip-as happening here. But when I turn on Duck, all that clipping goes away because we're losing all the distortion. That's kind of like the TLDR of how the anti-bow tying works. But check out this video and he will explain it in a much more in-depth way. But like I said, it's just a way to prevent all the clipping. And of course, if you're listening on good headphones, you'll hear this better. But like I said, sidechaining is primarily a mixing technique. And especially when it comes to sub basses versus kick drums, this is essential. To me, it's worth it. It was like 20 bucks. So totally go out and get this if you want just much cleaner mixes. Like, look at that, no clipping, no Duck. All the clipping because the drums and the sub are just fighting with each other. Duck keeps them from doing that. Yes. Now look at that, clean mix from this type of sidechaining, and I still have Ableton compressor sidechain because I like the pumping effect that it gives. And if you want more in-depth tutorials like this, my Patreon has a bunch of them, including Vital tutorial. I've got a few start to finish songs, more in-depth stuff like this where I like really dive into actual nerdy production stuff. So if you like this type of video, let me know. If you want to check more of them out right now, consider joining Patreon, helps out the channel, all that good stuff. Hopefully this all makes sense. If you have any questions, be sure to comment them below or follow me on Twitch. You can ask me questions there, we can hang out, do some production stuff. Oh yeah, I also mentioned there are probably free options of similar stuff like this, but I haven't checked them out, so I'm not gonna talk about them in this video. But other than that, that's gonna be all for today. Please like, subscribe if you've learned something, share it if it helped you out, follow me on Instagram, I see all your DMs, and other than that, I'll catch y'all later. Peace. See ya. Oh yeah, join Patreon too, because that helps support the channel. Bye!